Ritter section was first created in 1993, and its first exhibition was at the European Media Art Festival in Osnabrück, Germany. Since that time, it has been exhibited at 17 museums, galleries, and primarily festivals in North America, Europe, and Asia. In 2019, I decided to rebuild the installation. The new version is functionally similar to the original version. The difference primarily is that there is a wider selection of car sounds, and the infrared system is able to recognize the locations of people in the room a little more accurately. It still is an interactive sound installation, or now what is being called an immersive installation. The environment is a completely dark room. The only visual is a small, dimly lit exit sign. So when the audience enters this dark room, they will hear four lanes of car traffic moving randomly across the room. If they then venture into the installation and cross towards the exit sign, if they stand in front of the car as it is approaching, or more specifically in front of an audio speaker, then that car will come screeching to a halt and then sit there idling until the audience member gets out of the path. When that happens, then the car will then accelerate across the room, and then eventually the sound will fade out. Now, if the person remains standing in front of a stopped car for more than 7 seconds, subsequent cars will come down that lane and will smash into that parked car. This will keep happening until the person gets out of the lane, and at that point, then the cars will then accelerate across the room. Now, each lane operates independently of the others, so if you have at least 4 people, every lane can be blocked. And when that happens, the installation becomes quite chaotic because you have mixtures of cars screeching, accelerating, and smashing into each other. The installation itself, though, can really accommodate hundreds of people. The only limitation is the physical size of the room itself. It's not really limited by the infrared sensing system. Now, the audience's response to this installation, one type of person finds the installation extremely frightening, and the other type tends to find it very funny. But in general, it tends to provoke this emotional feeling of fear of some type.